My name is George Vasileiou. I moved to Canada actually at the end of 2012 from Greece. Built guitars and basses for almost 20 years right now. For the last 1.5 years, I'm very happy to work as a full-time guitar technician at Cosmo Music. I built electric guitars, mainly in electric basses and electric upright basses. And I do everything from scratch because I love the whole process of guitar making. So I design my own pickups, my own electronics. I do some pedals like overdrives, vintage fuzzes and choruses, compressors, both for guitars and basses. I try to use the best materials available, like the best tone woods I can afford. And I like to be involved in every stage of guitar making, from selecting the materials, designing the instrument, finishing and building mainly by hand, and I'm using hand tools. I don't like to work with CNCs. The only CNC that I can machine that I can use is the plec machine we have here at Cosmo. So I'm doing mainly the fretwork. Everything else is by hand. At the 80s, I was a classical guitar student. And I was very lucky because in my hometown, my teacher there is a luthier. He builds violins, cellos, double basses. So I remember that from the young age, I was exposed to images of open instruments and the procedure of building an instrument from scratch. Back then, there was not the internet, not so much information like YouTube and all that stuff. So I thought that it's very hard for some guy to learn how to do this. And I just forget it. The beginning of my journey in guitar making started with the beginning of the internet, actually. When I saw on YouTube that there are books and there are some DVDs of teach you how to make guitars, I went deeper into that because there's no music, no luthier school in Greece. So you have two options, or to start with a luthier, somebody that builds guitars, or learn by books and DVDs. And I remember that I bought everything available, like all the guitar made building books, guitar repairing books, and DVDs. And I remember I built my first guitar, and it was the late 90s. I still have the neck, and I make a new body, and my son still has this guitar. And that was the beginning. I get in touch with all the carpenters there in my hometown, so they did the hard work for me, like the planing and cutting the big pieces of wood, and everything else was shaping by me with just hand tools. And after a couple of years, because I used to play music professionally back then, I used to play with my own instruments, so friends and other fellow musicians saw my instruments and asked me to build something for them, something that began as a hobby for me, took a different direction. Say, okay, let's go deeper. And that's how I get into that. And when I left Greece, it was a period of my life that I was starting to get like a bigger reputation of that. Then I moved to Canada, so I have to stay away for a couple of years to make a new life, new beginning in the new country. I'm looking forward to go deeper into that again. Everything begins with the experience of the maker, okay? And for me, everything else comes second, like the materials, the woods, and the hardware and the pickups. Of course, the tone woods has a big impact on the tone, but high figured woods, sometimes it's more for aesthetic than the tone. You can get a fine instrument without like the exotic figured woods. Hardware is another very important piece of a component, because if you make a guitar, it's not a simple thing. It's like different components that all together give you like the final result. Eh? One of them is the tone woods. Another very important thing is the hardware. Then if we talk about electric guitars, it's the pickups, the choice of pickups. It's a huge chapter. The position of the pickups. So even if you have the same model and you move the pickups closer to the fretboard or closer to the bridge, you have different tones. Eh? So, and if you're looking for specific tones, you have to experiment with things like that. Bridge, tuners, nut, and good setup, there are all of these things that are very essential to get a high quality tone. And because I discover all those things by reading from the beginning, I try to go deeper into all of the stages. So that's why I try to make my own pickups. I went pickups about one decade, so about 10 years. And it was not always a success because there is a learning process on that, a learning period, and you need to have specific equipment so you can see somehow the changes of the tone regarding the tension of the wire that you use. And I have developed some pickup analyzer that can scan the frequency response of the pickup, and I can see that on my monitor. I have a database from vintage pickups, my own pickups. I can compare all the designs. So if I need a specific tone, like a trebler tone or a fatter tone, I know somehow what recipe to use to achieve that tone. Actually, I feel very proud, and sometimes you don't want to give the bass to the customer, but it's one of the best feelings you can have as a creator. Yeah? And I feel so good if I see some of the instruments in the hand of great players. And it's like a part of your soul or your work, it's in the tone, and it's a great feeling. Yeah, make me feel proud.